The value of this recognition with a special patent medal is, of course, that it supports continued research in basic biology. The entire group, hundreds of people who have been involved in this work over 50 years, 5 decades. At this time, there are 100 million edentulous in Europe, and in other parts of the world, there are almost billions. So it's a terrible number. And how could one combine this with using patents? The fact is that we here are facing a philosophical problem. Patents, money, and then who should get it?
How did you solve that problem?
We have tried to make a very small study or a very small project in Brazil, where we have a special hospital where the patients don't have to pay, and where doctors from all over travel and participate in the treatment. And this means that I feel that we have come to a situation where it is possible to avoid the money control, but only for a small number, because otherwise, cutting down the treatment cost is possible if you find the ambitious and philosophical doctors. Too many are edentulous, or they are born with defects, so that they feel that they are inferior to the neighbors. And this means then that based on decades of experience and observation, they can now move out and don't fear that they will drop a denture. You know, when it comes to the major parts of the skeleton, we have had several who have lost their limbs. And many years ago, there was a young girl who was hit by a tram and lost both her legs, her limbs, and the femur level high up. And she got fixtures, as we call the titanium components, and they became integrated and collaborating with the brain. And the fact is that she could feel what she was stepping on, the kind of carpet she was stepping on. There is one special application of osseointegration that's in the skull bone behind the ear for the bone-anchored hearing aid, which has proven very effective both for congenital problems, Richard Collins, but also for aging defects in hearing capacity. And that's something that already has been installed in 70,000 patients with very good results, 98%. The basic principles have been adopted by an increasing number of the companies. And because there are so many patients, then it's of great value for patients all over that there is kind of competition. Of course, the dominating number of possible patients are the edentulous ones. People live longer, and when they come up in 80, 85, they have lost their teeth, which deteriorates their quality of life, but and to eat and so forth. But then, of course, too many children are born with cleft lip, and that is a difficult situation, really, to decide when to install titanium fixtures in growing bone. Well, of course, now this procedure has been applied by many companies all over the world, and it's like €1 billion. You know, let me give you just an example. Quite a few of these patients who have lost a major part of their face, when they want to go out, they look into the mirror, and then they don't go out. And then, when they've got the anchorage, and if you have a very good prosthetic colleague, then they feel that, well, I am acceptable, I can go out. You know, it's interesting that if one considers when did this become a clinical reality, it was when we couldn't remove a titanium micro optics from the leg of a rabbit. And after further 10 years, we had a symposium in Toronto in 83. At that time, we understood that this was really not a micro thing. Patents are not at all considered when you have a very basic biologic problem. But over the years, I have discovered, and we have discovered, that without patents, what you have spent half your life on trying to understand is not yours anymore. I think it's positive because research should be free and not controlled by cashiers. The basic phenomena of osseointegration, osseoperception, are really providing a possibility to substitute with a bone-anchored prosthesis to the body of the human being, and controlled by communication with the brain of the patient. The invention really is based on the observation that the very special metal titanium installed in the human skeleton can become part of the patient forever. And to extend that, the only thing that remains of the patient after 1,000 years is the bone and titanium. The special phenomenon of osseointegration is that down at the nano level, titanium and bone and marrow unite. They unite, and you can't break it without using violence. And the intriguing thing is that even in elderly patients, 90 years, 100 years, does it work? So the titanium, in fact, then functions as an anchor for an incorporated non-biologic component in the human body. And it's recognized by the ordinary rejection capacity as acceptable.